requires patience.
Yes.
It requires a particular attitude. It requires a willingness to wait. It requires a willingness to deal with whatever comes with what you're waiting for. Waiting does not always have an expiration date. It does not always have a dictated date. But what it requires is your ability to do so. So what we need to do is have training exercises. Whether you know it or not, God has given us training exercises to help us with weight training. But we just don't recognize it. It starts with family. First of all, conceive. Yet you conceive. You've been conceived. I'm going to start from the infant part. You've been conceived. You can't do a thing.
Right.
Or you are just a speck because blood from a man has found a fertile egg of a woman.
Right.
Right.
And you can do nothing at all.
Right.
One month later, there's a mass there. And you can do nothing at all.
Right. Right.
2, 3, 4 months later, you might see some fingers, but you can do nothing at all.
Lord,
what he's doing, he's teaching you how to wait. Y'all don't hear me today. But you can't do nothing at all. He's just teaching you how to win. Have a lot of witnesses here. Go. 8 months later, you feel something you didn't feel in the 7th month. And you think you better get us to the hospital. Because I think the time has arrived. You get to the hospital and the doctor tell you, not now. You don't want to hear this anymore. How many times have you prayed and God said, not now? Wait, training. They send you back home. You say, I know my body has changed. And these pains are getting closer and closer together. I don't know why the doctor said, not now. Even in scripture, the Bible talks about the fullness of time. Too many times in church, we lose people because of a spiritual premature birth. We allow people because they got a feeling, and we tell them they're saved. Or can I talk to somebody today? Somebody started crying, and we told them they were healed. But God When God wants us to wait, how many of us never gave birth? Man. And you was pushing, the doctor said, don't push, come on, witness to me. And you just wanted that baby out, you was pushing, the doctor said, don't push. God! We want our children to be preachers so fast. And we push, and we push. But we won't wait. Not much. 40 weeks. But still, no birth. Can you see it? Wait. Let me go to the book. Wait. Now, somebody said, hey, we better induce labor. But wait, the Lord is in control. If God can put it in the belly, He can take care of it. Can you see it? He can take care of a preemie. He can take care of a pastor. I don't believe in pastor. I believe it's not your time yet. And when the fullness of time comes, after all, sacrament. When the fullness of time comes, the mother don't say, my wine broke. Oh, Lord, my feet. Apostle, can I preach it the way I really could? Now, he gave me permission. Now, my goodness is wrapped. When they broke the hymen, said the cherry was broken. But when the water breaks, there's no cherry wine. Is a stillbirth. I'm so glad. Yeah. I'm so glad that a war preceded our birth. But there was a wicked prophet. Well, there was a man. He waited 38 years. Did you see that? Patiently. All he wanted to do was just get in the water. He knew, if I could get in the water, my sins would be healed. Year number one, get to the edge. Somebody else would get on in. But I'm so glad. Dismayed.